try, could just call.
Maybe I should stop and think for a second.
You should stop and think, because I am sending it to you.
20.
No.
Just like in the movies, the award seasons will have their own villains. Movies that get nominations for categories that people just aren't really there for will say they try too hard or just not films that they may like. And for whatever reason this year, that has become Netflix's Maestro. This movie, which was directed by Bradley Cooper, acted by Bradley Cooper and Carey Mulligan are the two leads, is actually, I think, one of the best films of 2023. And for whatever reason, it got docked a lot of points publicly because it quote-unquote tried too hard. Now, Maestro is definitely a movie I can see might not appeal to a wide audience. I think some of the things Maestro does so well and why it should win Best Picture are things that sometimes the average moviegoer isn't exactly looking for in a movie. But that shouldn't disqualify all the effort that went in to make this magnificent movie for the type of people who are going to enjoy it. When I think of Maestro, I think of art in some of the most purest forms of 2023. To start the discussion first on why Maestro should win Best Picture, I think you have to look at who is running the core of this movie, and that is director-actor Bradley Cooper. Him playing Leonard Bernstein is an actual role that you can tell he cared very much about. He did big research with the family, with history, to deliver such a, I feel, realistic and well-purposed act, you know, character in performance. And I think the writing for the character and his point of view, you learn so much as somebody who doesn't know much about Leonard Bernstein, the good, the bad, and the ugly. I think Cooper is putting all of the effort you can ever imagine an actor in into providing a very realistic, groundbreaking, you know, performance. I find that he, as Leonard Bernstein, is just captivating to me. The way he's able to talk and the way he's able to act makes me feel like he's an actor in the 1960s, in the 1950s, even in the 70s and 80s as the movie progresses through time. I feel like Cooper is able to act out all the ages we see Leonard throughout the whole entire movie, is able to give so much heart in this performance, and for me, elicited a ton of emotion. Again, I know he's the villain of this award season for trying too hard to finally get an Oscar, but if you open your heart to Maestro and your eyes, I think you will find Cooper as one of the best performances of the year, and we really shouldn't be slighting him for trying so hard when I think his efforts went here ended up being for the positive. I think the other person in this acting duo you can really put a lot of positives are is Carey Mulligan. She's playing Felicia Feinstein's partner and wife throughout this whole entire movie. And Mulligan, again, is able to deliver a performance that goes through different ages, that shows a different point of view of Felicia all the way through, and what Felicia is trying to do with her own life, the positives and negatives of the relationship she has with Leonard Bernstein, her love for her family, her kids, and all the struggles that take place in a normal marriage and partnership and life. There's a lot that goes on to this performance, and Mulligan is able to nail it on every single level in terms of, you know, comedic, when there's comedic timings, really dramatic times. You really feel for Felicia throughout the whole entire movie. And in some ways, I think she's the main character and star as the movie goes on throughout the whole entire way. I just think that Carey Mulligan, again, she's up for Best Actress, like Cooper's up for Best Actor, and it's because she delivers such a great performance as this individual. And I don't understand, again, how people are watching this movie and are turning on it so hard when you have a performance like Carey Mulligan's in there. And I guess that her performance as Felicia is something that I've really enjoyed. Now, some of the other reasons why this movie could win Best Picture and should win Best Picture, the cinematography throughout is able to match all the different eras that it goes in, whether it be the 40s, 50s, and 60s black and white era, into your 70s type feel, into your like 80s and 90s. Simply put, I just feel that Maestro is able to, cinematography-wise, match the time period throughout. And that's so impressive to me in a modern age to make me feel like I'm watching movies of that era and it being able to go through that every era in a very authentic way. Then when I also think about it, I just think about all the technical craftsmanship. Things like the hair and makeup with Bradley Cooper and even Carey Mulligan is so impressive. The way you're able to do the production design, I think, is also very good in this movie. I think the way it's paced and edited, I think, you know, is worthy of a Best Picture. And I think the way it sounds, you know, Leonard Bernstein is a famous composer, and so much of this movie it will play either famous scores of his own or will have him playing music. And I just think it's such an underrated, appreciated category in what makes this movie work so well. And finally, I think this has one of the best scenes of the entire movie award season, and that is when, you know, Bradley Cooper as Leonard Bernstein is actually orchestrating kind of near the end of the movie, and it's a scene that is just very impressive, and you see the effort, you see the sweat, it just feels very authentic, real, and powerful. And I can't think of a better reason to why people should watch Maestro. Just alone for that scene, being able to see its place in the movie, I think Maestro is worth the watch. But everything together, it's hard. I know it's the villain of this award season, but Maestro is truly an amazing picture, and it's very much deserving of winning the Best Picture at the Oscars.